To our evening of chamber music. That was Michaela, Travis, and Dylan playing Procession of the Nobles. And for those of you that don't know what chamber music is, it's a pretty broad genre of music that is basically small ensembles. So it could be a group of two, it could be a group of six, it could be a solo. So it's just a general group of musicians playing a piece together. And it's really kind of a cool setting that gives the students a real opportunity to dig into music, and they get to rehearse these on their own with a little bit of guidance from us. And many of these, correct me if I'm wrong, Ms. Stella, but many of these were submitted for solo and ensemble.
Yes.
Yeah, many of these were submitted for solo and ensemble back in. Okay, was that in March? Yeah. So these were all submitted via video, which if you haven't gone through that process, that's a pretty awful process, because it's terrifying to play for a camera. As weird as that sounds, it's much easier to play for a live group of people than it is to play for a camera. So we wanted to give these students an opportunity to play for actual people instead of just a camera, because that's not really a whole lot of fun. So next up, we have a woodwind quintet, and you're looking here and going, wait, those aren't all woodwinds. That would be absolutely correct. French horn is usually grouped in with the woodwinds. And this is Allegro Molto by Mozart, and this will feature Victoria on flute, Ashton on clarinet, Marcel on oboe, Lily on French horn, and Harrison on bassoon. And between each of these, we'll just take a couple minutes to get set up. And let them play for you.
Thank you.
You know, we're really lucky at Cocke County to be able to have a woodwind quintet, because many high schools can't because they don't have oboes and bassoons. So we're lucky to have both an oboist and a bassoonist, as well as wonderful flutes, clarinets, and French horns. So we're really blessed here. Now, speaking of blessed, our next performer, Emma Zamora, a freshman flute player, is going to perform a traditional favorite hymn, Amazing Grace.
Okay, and next up we have a duo of trumpets that is going to be accompanied by Miss Sotelo, maybe? Are they coming? Okay. So this was originally done as a solo, however, we kind of revamped it a little bit so that they can play it together. So they'll be playing some of this together, playing some of the solo lead, and we ask that you hold your applause until after the fifth movement. Thank you. not going to let Kathy leave anywhere.
Oh, that's right.
You get to stay. Oh, I'm not pronouncing that French. Here, I'm going to pass this off to you.
Okay, so Mr. Driver had to tutor me in this French, but Haley Britney's next piece is from a pretty major work for saxophone. It's French, and the work is called Tableau du Provence.
Did I get that right, Mr. Driver?
He's back there, he didn't hear me. So anyway, she's doing the fourth movement, and it's got a really long, kind of complicated title. So we'll just say she's doing the fourth movement, and I think it's in your program. Okay, so there we go.
Thank you.
For the record, Rick said she was wrong.
Oh.
All right, next up, we got a couple clarinets, and it wouldn't be a COVID year if we didn't have to have someone fill in. So, Ms. Tello, if she can find a clarinet.
Oh, Captain Chair, it's the quartet. I get chairs.
Yes, it's the clarinet quartet. The chairs are over here, though. It's fine. We're all fine. So anyways, we're going to have a clarinet quartet. And again, it wouldn't be a COVID year if we didn't have to have someone fill in. So Ms. Atella is going to fill in for Katie Marty. And this is a fun little arrangement of classic Turkey in the Straw. Okay, and next up, we have Billy and Marcelo coming out here to play a duet. Billy was en glace. We'll give Billy a second to get his horn on. Is Marcelo coming? Sorry, there's quite a few people backstage, and moving around back there is kind of fun. I mean that in the worst possible way. Where are you going? Good job, guys. Okay, so next up, we have a whole gaggle of clarinets. I don't know what the right term is for a bunch of clarinets. We're going to have a bunch of clarinets coming out here, and they'll be joined by Isaiah and Michael Wiley. some rhythm section stuff. We're going to do a fun little jazz standard, Moonlight Serenade. And give us a second to get all the gaggle clarinets out here. That's the word I'm going to use for now. That's what I'm going with.
So next up, well, first of all, I hope you enjoyed the Moonlight Serenade. That's such a cool tune. I thought it sounded really good with the clarinet harmonies. So let me listen. Okay, that's better. So next up, we have our saxophone quartet from Cocke County, and they're going to play a classical piece by Bach called Symphonia No. 3. And when they get out here, this will be Haley Bricky and Harrison Sampson on alto, Kenny Sprouse on tenor, and Aiden Williamson on Barry. So, sax quartet sounds are so cool. I think you're going to love this. And I mean, you've seen Kenny out here a lot. He plays clarinet and tenor, so he's having a lot of switching up. All right, hope everybody's enjoying themselves tonight. after the sex quartet, we'll do a little jazz for you, and then our grand finale is the cool marimba duet. If you're at the spring concert, well, not to say spring, well, I guess it's spring concert, our film music concert, then you got a little taste of that. So that'll be really cool. Here's our Cocke County Sex Quartet.
Thank you.
So that is almost the end of as far as our true chamber music. We'll have one more here at the end after jazz band. So give us a couple minutes here to get pile out of the wings and get set up here for jazz band. So a couple things about this program. This is, as far as I know, Mr. Tell's on it, that this is the first time that we've ever had a program like this here. And this is, well, like an actual program. So this is just a great opportunity for our students. And excuse me while I continue to get set up for jazz band as I talk. I know most people who go to college for music, really chamber music is what really grabs a lot of musicians. Now there's a lot of people who like to just steal the spotlight and be a soloist. But chamber music, at least for me, and we were talking backstage and a couple of us, that was really kind of a highlight of our college careers, because I know that I did not get this type of opportunity in high school to do this. So it's really a great thing that we can offer this to our students. And I'm going to stop talking so we can get warmed up here and make sure I got all my stuff together. So our first tune up will be a tune that was made famous by the famous bassist Jaco Pastorius, and it's the Chicken, which I think is appropriate for us to play. And the soloist on that was Braxton Kelly on trombone and Missitello on tenor sax.
So our band this year, this one called Crystal Silence, which is a beautiful ballad, and just to kind of honor his memory. And in case you're not familiar with Chick Corea, he was a very famous keyboardist, a composer, a band leader, just a wonderful jazz musician. And he was actually born in 1941, but died in 2021. So I'm sorry. I get too emotional.
So this will feature Missitello on tenor sax, and oh yeah, me. I forgot about that. So, here's Crystal Silence.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so we're going to wrap up with one more. But while they are getting set up, I would like to draw your attention to the back page of the program, or as Ms. Brawley told me earlier, the menu, which I will now forever call it the menu. And on the back side, especially if you are a parent or guardian, there is a bunch of very important information on the back side that may or may not have made its way home to you. Okay. So on the left-hand side, there are the events that are coming up. Of importance is the band banquet on Thursday. You should have already RSVP'd for that. And money can get either turned in prior to or at the door. The very first full band rehearsal will be July 6th. Okay, July 6th at 6 in the band room. Percussion camp is those following couple days. The 7th through 9th from 9 to 5:30. That's the Wednesday, Thursday, Friday of that week. And then the week of July 12th starts band camp. I know it's scary to think about that already, but that is July 12th. On July 16th, which is that first Friday of band camp, there is a parent night, and we'll do our skits again, and it'll be a good time. So if you are a parent, please make sure you schedule to come to that. There'll be a bunch of information for you as a parent, especially if you're a new parent, or this is your first actual real marching band season. Because some of y'all who are our parents' freshmen have not had a real marching band season yet. And then on the right-hand side, there's a bunch of announcements that go along with that. There's the marching band show for next year, which is called the Red Marker. And you can see the songs listed there. Parents, make sure that your student that's in marching band in the fall has got their physical done prior to that July 12th date. The boosters meet every Monday night, and they do a bunch of stuff for us, both financially and volunteers, so please do get involved. And then band camp fees are $75, but there's ways to lessen that if you are able to, and that's all detailed there. Again, if you come to that parent night, that will all be explained then. And then if you have any questions, there are the three of our emails. And feel free to email us with any and all questions, concerns, cries of outrage, whatever that might be. Okay, so lastly, we have Isaiah and Victoria. And I'm not going to butcher the Spanish, but this is a brand new piece that I was part of a commissioning group of about 150 people, and we all pitched in a little bit of money to have a couple of marimba works for specifically geared towards high schools that have smaller marimbas. Okay, so this is a 4-octave marimba, and this is a 4 1/3-octave marimba. Most of the professional models have another between 8 and 10 keys on the end here. And those extra keys add about $10,000 on the price. So most of the high schools in the country that are not in Texas do not have access to that. So therefore, they don't have access to a lot of the new literature that is coming out. I've been put together this commissioning project, this is one of the pieces from Songbook Volume 4.3. And again, I'm not going to butcher the Spanish. I hope you enjoy this. Thank you. I guess we should have warned you about the clapping.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that is the end of our program. We'd like to thank you all for coming. We'd like to especially thank our admin, which I know Gail and Kendra and Nancy are all here, and thank you so much for coming. They really do support us hugely and greatly. Well, that's super great English. I'm sorry, Gail. But they really do support us, and that is not found everywhere. I have many band director friends that are very jealous of the support that we get from our admin, both here at the high school and also over at central office. So that's really a great thing. So thank you again for coming. I'm going to do this again. This is what I did the last time. If you feel so moved, so like motivated to give a donation, I believe Miss Holly will be sitting outside the door. If you would like to give, don't please do not feel obligated to. It's just there if you would like to. She'll be sitting out there to take any of that. And just thanks and thank you again for coming. This means a lot to us and to our students to come out and support these kids who have put in a whole lot of work. We push them real hard for a COVID year. Thank you for coming.